Hi, I'm Nick from GitLab Security Team. In January 2024, we fixed a critical security vulnerability. In this video, I'll show you what happened, how it worked, and what you need to know to stop similar issues happening in the future. This bug was 10 out of 10 severity. That's bad. It's so bad that the USA's government has noticed it being exploited in the wild. In other words, baddies are using it against our customers. Not great. Here's how it works. Probably the easiest way to think about it is our password reset page lets you input a single email address. But with this bug, an attacker can add a second email address. The password reset email will go to both email addresses. And if you don't have multi-factor authentication enabled, the attacker can change your password and take over your account. So why does this bug even work? Ruby on Rails is flexible when it comes to classes and typing. It's a dynamically typed language. Unless you tell it to, it doesn't care if a request's query parameter is a string or an array of strings. In the first code example, email is a string. The database query we use to find the user will return whichever user, if any, has that email address. In the second code example, email is an array of strings. The database query we use to find the user will return the first one that matches any of the email addresses. Where the bug arose is that we used that unsafe URL parameter in two places. First, to find the user. Second, to send them the password reset email. When we find the user, we get one user. When we send the email, it goes to two addresses. Let's look at the actual code that introduced the bug in the GitLab codebase. It's important to note that the merge request that introduced the bug had all the right reviewers, including an AppSec review, but this bug was subtle and not easy to spot. The goal was that, since GitLab users can have multiple verified emails, you should be able to send a password reset email to any of them. We used the devised Ruby gem to provide password reset functionality. In the original code, user input is not sanitized, but it doesn't matter. Whether email is a string or an array of strings, it will only ever send a password reset email to the user whose password is being reset. The action calls send reset password instructions, passing resource params. Resource params is unsanitized, it's almost the same as a regular Ruby hash. Remember that. Send password reset instructions finds a single user using the email attribute, then sends the reset instructions. Devise's default headers fetch the email from that user resource, and there's no security flaw there. That is, until we created a module to override Devise's default behavior. We changed send reset password instructions. Attributes, you'll remember, is a hash of request parameters. Since we haven't sanitized it, at this point it could be an array of emails or a single email. We wrote our own method to find the user whose password is being reset, calling byEmailWithErrors, which calls findByAnyEmail. When email is an array, and when the attacker's email doesn't exist in the database, the victim's user record will be returned. So we have a single user record, the victim, but we still have email as an array of emails, including the attacker's email. Looking back at the device mailer, the final command it runs is to override its default headers by calling merge. It is at this point that the to header is changed from a single email address to two email addresses. That's why the password reset email goes to both the attacker and the victim. So how do we fix this, and what do we need to do differently in the future? This particular type of vulnerability can be avoided if we perform input validation using Rails' strong parameters feature. With strong params, if the value is an array, an error is thrown. It won't look up a user, it won't pass an array of emails to the notification method. Wherever we have a Rails controller expecting input, we should be using strong parameters. We now have a RuboCop that enforces this, but there's a backlog of exceptions and we could use your help. Check the video description for a link. More generally, Always validate the input a user gives you before you use it, store it, or pass it to a downstream service or delayed job. If you're writing a service that uses values provided by a user, revalidate the input again, just in case. When we fix the bug, we explicitly cast the email parameter to a string. Now an attacker can't sneak two values through. We also flip the logic, so instead of doing a lookup on the user table and sending to an email, we do a lookup on the email table and get the user off that. We also explicitly set the to header calling email.email, which will always return a single string. There's no way for us to confuse an attacker and a victim here, so the bug was fixed. But it's always safest to assume a similar bug could occur again. We also added defense in depth checks for our other email methods. We now validate that the to header always contains a single string, that the string doesn't have comma separated emails in it, and that the CC and BCC fields are empty. This vulnerability was critical because it allowed attackers to take over accounts that didn't have multi-factor authentication set up. That includes administrators. So we also added a feature where customers can enforce that all administrators have MFA enabled. The attacker needed to know the victim's email address. Until recently, when you installed GitLab, the initial admin account was set with a hard-coded and guessable email address, admin@example.com. So we randomized the default email address and asked the administrator to change it when they first sign in. A huge thank you to all involved in the many efforts to both fix the bug and also add defense in depth measures to prevent similar vulnerabilities in the future. Has this video sparked a thought or a concern? Add a to-do to go and review that code. If you find something, use the vulnerability issue template to alert the application security team. Check out the video description for more links. If you have questions, visit #secprodsec in Slack. And thanks for watching.